Black Patriarch.
The Republican National Committee is honoring Black history this year during its fourth annual luncheon in Daytona Beach on the campus of Bethune-Cookman University. The RNC celebrated Black History Month by awarding former Housing and Urban Development Secretary Alfonso Jackson with a Trailblazer Award. Members also discussed spreading knowledge about the GOP to people in poverty-stricken areas.
I do believe that we're going to have a Republican president, and we will begin to see the country turn around. We're still in a very stagnated state, and the only way to get out of that state is to get someone who understands what our country needs today. You
all. The RNC says their main focus right now is to make sure urban areas are aware of how the Republican Party works.
My sisters and brothers were very wonderful human beings. We were extremely close-knitted. My father worked three jobs. He was a very, very strong man. I tell people all the time, I'm sitting here with 3 degrees and I'm still not as smart as my dad. He really cared about the education of his kids, even though he did not have a formal education as we know it today. My dad used to say that the only limitations to your dream are between your 2 ears. Dream it and you can accomplish it. I had a great deal of faith in myself. If anyone had told me I'd be sitting in a presidential cabinet, I would have said, no, that's not going to happen, but it did. And I believe truly this could not have happened in any other country in the world other than America.
President Bush and I are committed to working with many governments around the country, and we have, so that they will have the opportunity to understand how we have been successful in our country.
In the midst of our housing crisis, the Bush administration's top housing official today resigned. Housing and Urban Development Secretary Alfonso Jackson is, by the way, leaving for family reasons, as he put it. He's also under criminal investigation for giving lucrative government contracts to personal friends.
Amid historic turmoil in the nation's housing market, the Secretary of Housing and Urban Development has decided to quit.
There come a time when one must attend diligently to personal and family matters. Now is such a time for me.
That following calls for Jackson's removal, the latest from two key senators, stating, quote, we are deeply troubled by the growing number of allegations of impropriety on the part of HUD Secretary Alfonso Jackson. We call on you to immediately request Secretary Jackson's resignation, end quote. At issue, charges of cronyism and falsehoods, beginning with a 2006 speech by the HUD secretary in Dallas, where he said he denied federal business to a contractor who said he didn't like George Bush. Jackson later said that was basically a lie, but his troubles didn't end there. ethics watchdog group lawyer Melanie Sloan.
There's been lots of controversies with Mr. Jackson getting involved in contracting issues.
Questioned HUD contracts in New Orleans and the Virgin Islands to Jackson friends. An accusation by the Philadelphia Housing Authority that Jackson threatened to withhold federal dollars after it rejected a deal with another friend. And questions from some members of Congress over whether he's been completely forthcoming with them.
Certainly he leaves under a cloud, and this is the worst kind of cloud to leave under in terms of how you did these contracts, not doing them on the up and up.
HUD's inspector general found no, quote, direct evidence of political favoritism, but did note that in many cases where Jackson interjected himself in a contract decision, the contractor had, quote, Democratic affiliations.
Here we got a mayor in our city and our president of the United States who have passed legislation and have given up funding to create opportunities for new citizens to come into the United States, ignoring people who have been born and raised here.
With the president setting aside all of these funds for immigrants and forsaken African-American community and African-American families, I think that's a disgrace.
Patriarch.